A horrific incident took place in Thari, an urban village near Noida, India, 3 years earlier during 2004 and 5. It involved sexual abuse, murder, cannibalism and attempted necrophilia on victims as young as 4 years. A series of disappearances of young girls and boys, teenagers, and a 20-year-old prostitute in 2005 were eventually traced to the home of Moninder Singh Panda. A wealthy businessman lived in a large house near Thari, away from his family and with his caretaker, Zurinder Kali. When the incidents happened continuously, the resident complained in nearby police station. Initially, the local authorities ignore their complaints. The local authorities repeatedly ignored the residents' complaints. Then they decided to solve the case themselves. Therefore, they sought the help of former Resident Welfare Association President S.C. Misra. In the early morning, Misra and the two residents searched a tank drain and found a decomposed hand, after which they called the police. This news spread in the area, and many parents of missing children rushed to the police station. Initially, some police officers, including Noida SP City, denied any criminal angle. They accused the parents for giving wrong information about their children's age. The police claimed that missing cases are not related to kids. The residents alleged that the police were corrupt and were paid to conceal information. Demands were made for an independent probe into the matter. Two policemen were suspended on the 31st of December in connection with the serial murders as angry residents charged the house of the alleged mastermind. The policemen were suspended for dereliction of duty in the wake of the allegations by the locals that the police had refused to take any action when they were informed about a number of children missing. The situation at Thari was aggravated as an angry mob of villagers fought pitched battles with the police, both pelting stones at each other. In the meanwhile, the police had arrested Mr. Zurinder Kali and his boss Mr. Pandhar as suspects. During investigation, Zurinder Kali confessed of murdering a Vakal girl, her name was Payal. After Kali's confession, the police claimed to have started digging up the nearby land area and discovered the children's bodies. As more body parts were dug up, near the premises. The next day, 15 of the 17 skeletons discovered in the area were identified. 10 of them were identified by Kali when he was confronted with the photographs of the missing children. 5 others were identified by family members after being shown belongings recovered from the scene. On 1 January 2007, the remand magistrate granted the police custody of Panda and Kali until 10 January, as the investigators said that further interrogation was required to complete the recovery of victims' remains. The court also granted permission for narco analysis. The security was increased as police expected more disturbance, following 2 days of violence near Panda's residence. In a press statement, Chief Justice of India Y.K. Sabharwal asserted that the investigation was at a preliminary level, and neither the courts nor the Central Bureau of Investigation were involved at that point. The central government, however, constituted a high-level inquiry committee to go into the police lapses during the period of reporting and investigation. This committee would take stock of the efforts made by the Noida police in locating the children who went missing. The inquiry committee submitted its reports indicting the Uttar Pradesh police for gross negligence in handling the cases of missing persons. After reeling under a lot of relentless pressure and public outcry, the Uttar Pradesh government suspended 2 superintendents of police and dismissed 6 policemen for dereliction of duty. The 2 accused in the case were already in police custody while the skeletal remains of the young children were being unearthed from behind and in front of Panda's residence. The committee investigated many other possible angles of the case on the basis of the evidences and circumstances, like child pornography racket, suspicions of organ trade and cannibalism. During investigation, Zurinder Klee also revealed that all deaths had taken place through strangulation. He would then rape them before taking the bodies to his personal washroom and dismembering them. Panther was declared to be a womanizer and depressed. After 4 days of discourse and mounting pressure from the government of India, the Uttar Pradesh government decided to hand over the inquiry to the Central Bureau of Investigation. The CBI continued its investigation and discovered 3 more skulls and human remains at the site of the serial killings. The investigators searched the drains outside the house and found 3 skulls, believed to be of the children, and several body parts, including parts of legs, bones, and torso. Several objects were found that are believed to belong to the victims. The discovery of several polythene bags containing parts of human torsos led the investigators to conclude that it was unlikely that the accused had links to illegal organ trade. The CBI team discovered the bags in the drains outside the Panther residence. After interrogating Zurinder Klee, they came to a prima facie conclusion that he is a psychopath used to carry out the killings. Pyle was the only adult victim in the string of serial murders. Young girls constituted the majority of victims. Post-mortem reports of the 17 sets of skulls and bones recovered showed that 11 of the killed were girls. On 12 February 2009, both the accused, Moninder Singh Pandya, and his domestic servant Zurinder Klee were found guilty of the 8 February 2005 murder of Rimpa Haldar by a special sessions court in Ghaziabad. On 10 September 2009, the Allahabad High Court acquitted Moninder Singh Pandya and overturned his death sentence. He was not named a main suspect by investigators initially, but was summoned as co-accused during the trial. Panther faces trial in 5 cases out of the remaining 12, and could be re-sentenced to death if found guilty in any of those killings. The same day Panther was acquitted, the Allahabad High Court upheld the death sentence for Zurinder Klee, the former domestic servant of Panther. On 24 July 2017, both Klee and Panther have been awarded the death sentence in the latest hearing by the CBI court at Ghaziabad. Kindly don't forget to like and subscribe our YouTube channel for more stories. Thank you for watching this video.